Hello, brothers and sisters. This is Pastor Mark Brown of Holy Hills of Zion coming to you with our midweek moment. For the last couple of weeks, we've been talking about relationships and how the power of love can bring forth relationship. We start out with an agape love, which is a godly love that brings our relationship with God into being. Last week, we talked about phileo love, and this is the brotherly love that allows us to experience relationship within community, within church, in our neighborhoods with our brothers and sisters and friends. This week, I want to talk to you about Eros love, which is an intimate love God designed for a relationship between a man and a woman. When you look at relationships in today's world, they are not exactly what God designed them to be, are they? In fact, I would say that there are some marriages where the couple is not necessarily in a relationship with one another. And then there are some relationships where the couple is not married. But this is not what God designed or intended for Eros, which is the love between man and woman, to be. So I want to share with you just a couple of things that God poured into my spirit that helped me along the way, and I pray that will bless you. I am by no way a relationship expert, but again, I just pray that as it has blessed me, it would also be a blessing to you. Number one, always be willing to learn from your mistakes. Understand, brothers and sisters, we all make mistakes. There is no perfect marriage, no perfect relationship, no perfect person, in fact. So many of us have made relationship mistakes. Some have made mistakes today, and some of us are yet going to make these mistakes in the future. But God is not so much concerned about the mistake that we make in the past as He is concerned that we do not continue to make the same mistakes. You have to be willing to learn from your mistakes. If a relationship doesn't work out the way you want it to, always be willing to learn and gain experience and wisdom so that you'll be better prepared for the next person that God may bring into your life. So always be willing to learn from your mistakes. When you look at your mistakes with regret, it will only make you bitter, not better. Number two, always remember to make sure that your relationships have goals and plans. Always make sure that your relationships are on the road to somewhere so they don't end up on the road to nowhere. As a couple, you have to work together to make sure that you're always working and striving to be better as a couple, as individuals, and bringing your family into a better being. Always make sure that you have goals that you're working towards. It will help you to endure the difficult times. Number three, always remember you are the expert when it comes to your relationship. No one can tell you better about your relationship than you can. There will always be people that have advice to give and things they want to share with you. But be careful of where you get your advice from, but also be careful on what advice you choose to use. All the relationship books, seminars, self-help experts, and all those with a 10-point plan to give you a perfect relationship, all they have to offer you is information. And when it comes to information, you must be careful to realize what worked for some may not work for you. So always remember that you are the expert when it comes to your relationship. Seek the voice of God. Seek the direction of God when it comes to the one that you love and you share your life with. God will guide you, but you have to remember that you are the expert when it comes to your relationship. And the last thing I want to share with you is always be careful on wasting energy in your relationship. You know, God has given us a power inside of all of us. The Bible tells us in 1 John 4:4, greater is He that is in you than he that is in the world. So we all have this power inside of us, this agape love that will allow us to build relationships and put the energy in that will give us a relationship that can last a lifetime. But many times when it comes to marriage and relationships, couples focus on the minor instead of paying attention to the major. So when it comes to your relationship, always make sure that you are investing more energy in loving each other than you invest in hating each other. Always make sure you invest more energy in forgiving one another than you invest in offending one another. Always make sure that you invest more energy talking to each other than you invest arguing with each other. And always make sure, brothers and sisters, you invest more time building the relationship up than you spend in tearing the relationship down. When we understand that we're all going to make relationship mistakes, but we're willing to learn from them, When we're willing to stay focused in our relationships and remind each other of what we're working towards during the difficult times. When you realize that you are the only expert when it comes to your relationship or marriage. And when you make sure you invest your energy in building things that will last instead of tearing them down. We will begin to see the fruit of God in our relationships, and we will begin to see growth. I pray that this midweek moment has been a blessing to you. Join us at Holy Hills of Zion, where our services are held on Sunday morning at 11 a.m. and our midweek service at 7 p.m. If you would like information on this message or any other messages we have, please feel free to call us at 757-788-8040. Again, this has been Pastor Mark Brown with our midweek moment. Until we see each other again, may God bless you and me. Stand.